Slăvit să fie Domnul! A fost o seară minunată, a fost o seară în care Dumnezeu ne-a vorbit, a fost o seară în care Dumnezeu ne-a atins inima și pot să spun cu toată inima mea, a fost o seară specială în care și inima mea s-a încărcat și după cum vedeți, aproape 5.000 de oameni care au fost aici în sală au simțit atingerea Duhului Sfânt și nădăjduiesc ca și dumneavoastră în fața ecranului să fie avut harul acesta, să fie avut parte de dragostea lui Hristos care, uite, prin televiziunea Credo a ajuns în casele dumneavoastră. Permiteți-mi ca înainte să spun ceea ce vreau să spun, permiteți-mi să mulțumesc echipei Credo TV. Fără ei, fără efortul lor, fără viziunea lor, fără slujirea lor, dumneavoastră acum nu ați fi avut parte de transmisiunea în direct de la această 48-a convenție a Bisericilor Penticostale Române din Statele Unite și Canada. Domnul să-i binecuvânteze și să-i ajute ca lucrarea aceasta de media să meargă în continuare. Ca un partener, colaborator și prieten al televiziunii Credo TV, mă bucur să fiu aici, mă bucur că am reușit să avem o ediție specială a ziarului Tribuna Românească, pe care o distribuim astăzi la toți cei participanți și în zilele următoare în comunitatea românească. Bucuria mea că slujesc Domnului prin acest ziar românesc este foarte mare, dar în seara aceasta bucuria mea este și mai mare pentru că am alături de mine un prieten foarte bun, fratele Neville Verster, care este director în organizația Alliance Defending Freedom. Foarte mulți dintre dumneavoastră știți despre cazul Bodnariu și știți că drepturile religioase ne sunt încălcate. Ați aflat doar o mică parte a ceea ce se întâmplă în lume cu acest caz. Ați aflat ulterior, sau poate chiar și înainte, că în Statele Unite dreptul creștinilor este încălcat. Drepturile noastre constituționale sunt ignorate de prea multe ori. Ei bine, Alianța pentru Apărarea Libertății, Alliance Defending Freedom, luptă exact pentru aceasta. Este cea mai mare asociație ce însumează peste 3.000 de avocați creștini în Statele Unite și tot cam atâția și în Europa. Fratele meu, Neville, este director pe program de comunicare și de promovare a acestei organizații. De fapt, are un program de ambasadori prin care ceea ce se întâmplă cu Alliance Defending Freedom merge mai departe. Neville, Steven, let me welcome you on Credo Television in front of a live audience that has been watching the convention. Yes. Is very excited. God spoke. He touched our hearts and he touched the hearts of the TV watchers.
Well, that is fantastic, and it should do exactly that.
You feel so charged. This is your first experience in such a large gathering of Romanian brethren. How do you feel?
Well, I'll tell you what, it definitely was very, firstly, I appreciate the invitation. It was beyond my expectations. I knew that it was going to be big, but I did not know what was going to be occurring. I am thrilled, I'm very uplifted. Jesus was definitely glorified here this evening. The Lord is well pleased, I am certain, because he was honored. And I think what really appeals to me so greatly was to see such worshipful occurrences here, to see young people just sold out for the Lord. And it's a wonderful, wonderful thing to be in a gathering of people that are just so enthused about worshiping God.
You have about 5,000 brothers and sisters that were here, about 10% of them were on the stage singing and worshiping, and you were raising your hand and you were enjoying it. How do you feel? 5,000 Romanian brothers and sisters.
Well, you know, it tells me that this is just a mere little taste of what we will look forward to at the point in time that our lives on earth are over, because we know that we will be around the Bema seat as believers in Jesus, and we will be worshiping him. And when we can encounter these kinds of events, Stephen, to me that is just a mere little taste of what is coming down the road for us. That
brothers and sisters of different nationalities and different languages even,
but yet we can still unify in glory to the Lord.
10 years ago, were you thinking when you first went to Romania, and that was your only chance yet, more is to come, but when you first visited Romania, what have you thought that one day you'll be sitting in a live audience and enjoying the worship like you did tonight?
You know, Stephen, going to Romania was an extremely special thing for me.
It touched my heart very deeply.
And today when I was talking to about 150 pastors, I mentioned, you know, every guest that comes always says, oh, I feel so honored that you brought me here. But I really did feel so honored because I've been to a lot of countries in this world. But being in Romania, touching hands with some of the young people and seeing the hunger for the Lord, talking to the older people to see the previous regime, the Ceausescu regime under communism, how it suppressed the livelihood, the fundamental freedom desire that people have. That was a wonderful thing to see there now, the refreshness of being open in their worship. And I got to see that here again tonight. And so that was wonderful.
Awesome. But what did you really come here for this weekend? You came all the way from Scottsdale, Arizona. And by the way, dear brothers and sisters, Alliance Defending Freedom is an organization that works out of Phoenix, Arizona, out of Scottsdale, but is all over the world. What did you really come out here for?
Stephen, I came here this weekend to bring a message of encouragement and a message of hope and a message of letting the church know that Alliance Defending Freedom is doing the job that they may not necessarily know. There's a certain vernacular in America which is called, I've got your back, and that is what ADF is doing. My message this weekend to the pastors was, friends, take the time. Go on our website, just take a look and see what Alliance Defending Freedom is all about. Because pastors, here's the deal. You know, 10 years ago, what it required to be a good pastor in the United States, or I dare say anywhere in the world, was a heart after Jesus, an understanding of the word, which you're going to get probably from a good seminary. And then you needed to have elders and a good congregation. That is typically what it took to be a good pastor. But not today. Today you need all of those. And you need an attorney. Friends, you need an attorney, because if you are unprotected, there are churches that are being closed down because the church and the pastor were unprepared for what is coming down. It must be very clear to all of us, there's a cultural tsunami that is occurring because the church is not the best friend of the culture. It wasn't for Jesus and it isn't for us right now either.
Și astăzi, realitatea este că fiecare comunitate de credincioși au nevoie de asistență legală în forma unui avocat.
Alliance Defending Freedom has had 22 years of experience in protecting the church.
Alianța noastră în apărarea libertății este în existență de peste 22 de ani.
And like I so often ask my friends, were it not for an organization, a ministry like Alliance Defending Freedom, without by winning all of those Supreme Court cases, what would have been our world in religious freedom if we did not do that? If Alliance Defending Freedom was not there? By the way, friends, it's not just in the United States. In the brief 6 years that we have been in Europe, we have already won the equivalent of eight.
Și organizația nu este doar în Statele Unite, ci este și în Europa. Și am câștigat mai multe procese chiar în Europa pentru apărarea libertăților de a sluji Domnului după cugetul care l-are fiecare.
Contact us so that we can engage with them. We can feed them information. Here's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for an information agent in your church to feed you information so that you are well equipped. And may I just take one more moment? Pastors, let me give you an idea. If you have not changed your bylaws or your constitution within the last 5 years, let me tell you that this book is going to be a valuable godsend to you, because our team of over 60 qualified constitutional attorneys have re-examined much of what used to be considered okay and is now not okay because of such assault by the LGBT community, particularly by the various human rights biserica și dreptul de a funcționa ca și biserică după principiile Sfintelor Scripturii. ACLU and Planned Parenthood, many of them whose names you know, inside of this book, you will have templates to change your laws, your bylaws, your constitutional bylaws, and you will be able to protect yourself so that if indeed anybody arrives at your church and you are subject to anti-discrimination, you will be protected. So avail yourself. Here's the news. It's free. We don't charge you anything.
Aceasta este gratuită.
Why? Because we have benefactors, donors who support the ministry because of
pentru că avem suficienți donatori care susțin această misiune.
They love Christ and we're doing everything we can to protect.
Aceste persoane iubesc pe Domnul Iisus Hristos. So that we can be of help. Și ne puteți să luați legătura cu noi pentru că ajutăm.
I can't stress enough the fact that you've just been in touch with our community for a few good months. You've been watching how the community rallied around the Bodnariu case.
Yes.
And people at ADF became interested in us. We were interested in ADF. And here we are building a relationship.
Yes.
First of all, I am honored to be on your team. I am honored to be one of the ambassadors on your team, and I am also very, very honored to have Pastor Cristian Ionescu. Yes, Pastor Cristian Ionescu has been invited to be the next ambassador to join the team, and he will lead a team of other Romanian pastors coming on board. How do you feel about all these pastors that you've been talking to these last couple days? How do you feel about that?
Stephen, what it tells me is
cum
that they get it.
De progresul
they
făcut
get
în comunitatea română, inclusând involvarea fratelui Cristionescu și a celorlalți.
That they are prepared to do something, you know?
Mă simt
and
foarte bucuros și anticipez lucruri mari pentru că acești oameni lui Dumnezeu sunt gata să acționeze făcând ce trebuie să facem.
But we don't unnecessarily need to be foolish by inviting all kinds of difficulties in our lives when there are ready-made solutions to protect the community. And that's what our goal is to be able to keep the doors of the church open. Because we have numerous examples where the doors were closed because of the cultural and the legal circumstance that we all live in today.
Many of them were well aware of the fight that we're putting with the devil these days and how the devil is launching its attacks on the church. And they felt like there is a need for an organization like Alliance Defending Freedom. And I saw that you were encouraged as you were speaking to them. But your message goes a lot further, doesn't it? Not just to the pastors that were here and not just to the Pentecostal pastors, but it goes to all the other pastors, all the other priests,
yes,
and all the other people that are active somehow in spreading the gospel over the world.
That is the word.
Missionaries.
That is so.
All sorts of
that
ministries.
So. Yes.
Brother, I am blessed that you have accepted our invitation to be with us.
I thank you so much.
I am blessed that Alliance Defending Freedom has partnered with the Romanian community, and we can say that we are living right now new beginnings, and we are proud that we can bring something to the table. First of all, we bring an army of prayer warriors, and that's what we are asking every single one of you. If you can put it in your calendar, put it on your on a note, and put it to the refrigerator, stick it onto the refrigerator, and every time you see that note, please remember to pray for Alliance Defending Freedom, for all the Christian lawyers, and for everybody that shares the vision. Brother Neville, I thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Please give my very best regards and God blessing to the pastors.
I appreciate the invitation to be here, and we are looking forward to engaging
in a greater way with the Romanian community, because the love that I saw here this evening, the bonding that this community has, it fills my heart to see this, and I thank you for that experience.
I thank you. God bless you.
God bless. Bye-bye, Stephen.